Welcome back to Nerdy TV. We interview local street figures and rappers from all over New York. Stay tuned. All right, man. If the people not in tune with who you is, man, if the people don't know who you is, man, let them know who you is, man. Let them know what you stand for and all that.
It's your boy, 11-9 Nas, a.k.a. Nas here, a.k.a. Nas, you feel me? But y'all call me 11-9 Nas. Like, fuck all the odd types, you feel me?
All right, man. So I know you just had dropped a project like 2-3 months ago. Like, do you got any other projects in the works, like an album, a mixtape, or are you just gonna let this, the mixtape that you had dropped like 2-3 months ago rock for like a year or two? Like, what's the update status on that?
I got upcoming projects, a mixtape dropping soon, non to the work. Like, my man said it's non to the nothing. Some niggas wasn't claiming me from the other games and shit. They said it's not to nothing. So my mixtape will be non to the question mark, not to the what.
Alright, man. So I'm really looking forward to that mixtape or whatever. Hopefully it can drop soon enough. Hopefully it got good production. But as soon as it drop, I'm on that. I really want to hear that. I'm really looking forward to that. If you can name a couple songs that's just hard that you ever made or been on collab or not, could you name a few? What's your best songs that you feel like you really did just, you know, you really did just your stuff on that song? Like, can you name a couple songs?
I got a lot of certain songs that's fire. Most of my songs is fire. 9 to the 9, Up It, Good Weed, 11-9, Do It Again. I got a whole lot of nice songs, bro. More songs on that mixtape better be dropping. And it's just like that, bro. You just gotta wait.
Alright, man, since you're on the music topic, let's talk about music inspirations, like, that made you want to start rapping. Like, it could be old school rappers from LA, Snoop Dogg. Like, let's hear some of your inspiration that made you want to start rapping or whatever.
Music inspirations? Yeah. My son K thinks my inspiration. My son Duda. But K thinks mostly. He makes me rap and do what I do now.
I know you're not the biggest artist, like, the biggest average artist right now coming out of New York. Like, but I know you street famous when it comes to rapping. Like, a lot of people know you for rapping and all that. Is there a little bit of local labels knocking on your door, like, that want to sign you and all that? Do people actually want to sign you? Or is you going to sign if a person tries to sign you? Like, what's the status on that?
Nah, actually, I'm not signing no labels or nothing, bro. You feel me? I feel like I don't got time for a label. A label's not trying to sign me right now. I'm going to keep it a band. I still got to work hard on my music, upgrade my music, and more shit like that.
So we were just talking about your mixtape and whatever, when is it gonna drop or whatever. When you say mixtape, I know it gotta be a couple features on there. Like, you got a couple collabs coming out, like, what's up with that?
Collabs? Yeah, I got upcoming collabs. I got collabs probably with my son T, my son. I got collabs coming up on Rich, Stacks, probably Kane, probably Duda. You just gotta wait, bro, honestly. More collabs, more shit to come. I got a collab up with Rico, bro. I got a collab with niggas, bro. Just the music, bro. I'm finna take off with this shit for real, bro. Feel me? I'm finna take off with this shit.
Alright, so I know, like, a month back, and almost a couple weeks back, you got into a little situation where K-Thing was locked up. Rich spoke on in his interview, you know, like, can you speak on that? Like, did you go to jail when it came down to that situation?
Nah, I never been in jail, but I almost been in jail one time, because I was like, bro, we was trying to get back one day, bro. I'm not going to get too federal, but we was trying to get back one day, bro. And then, like, so we went to Murderside, which is known, the old T-Town, which is known as Murderside now. We were sliding over there, and there's some bitch-ass nigga named Jaw Flag. I'm joking. He called the police or whatever. Well, we got in the high speed. Let's just get straight to the point. We got in the high speed or whatever, and then type shit. So we went to Central Park and all shit like that. So Niggas was driving, niggas, you feel me? But my son K-Thing got arrested that day. But he's out now. While we speaking right now, he's out. But the time that I almost got arrested, K-Thing got arrested. But all the niggas that was in jail that I really knew like that is out now. My son E-Dot is out. Shout out to Nod, shout out to gang type shit. Just shout out to the whole gang. That's all I want to say for real. My brothers and all more shit. But nah, I never been in jail, bro.
I know when it comes to the street shit, a lot of people lose multiple people. Like, most people have lost multiple people, you know? Like, have you lost people? Like, have you lost a close friend of yours?
Yeah. I lost a lot of people in the game, bro. Like that's what I'm trying to tell us, the people, bro. Don't be in the streets, bro. The streets is not everything, bro. The streets may be cool to niggas or whatever, but look, bro, my homies told me the streets is not cool, bro. Niggas laughed at me because I went to school, bro. Believe it or not, bro. The streets is not good. You lose a lot of people in the fucking streets, bro. I lost one of my best friends in the streets, bro. My son P Money, bro. I lost my fucking best friend. My two best friends, but my main best friend, I lost my best friend, bro. We was on the block chilling, bro. Like, it's just crazy, bro. Like, this shit is crazy, bro. Like, RP P Money, RP the gods, bro. Hilltop King.
I know that must be a sad situation that you have to go throughout. You know, I can only imagine. Like, when you wake up, you gotta relive that moment almost. Every day, it's a very unfortunate situation because the kid was only 15, you know, RPP money as well. Like, back in the interview, I asked you, what was your music inspiration? I asked you about all type of music questions, like labels and all that, but I never asked you, what's your top five in Harlem? Like, it could be from, they don't even gotta be from Harlem, they could be from Jersey, Staten, the Bronx, they could be from anywhere. Like, what's your top five? Like, I'm ready to hear that. Like, what's your top five?
Top 5 rappers. Alright, let's see. At 1, it would be my son Kane. 2, Duda. Then 3 would be Trap Boy. 4, it would be Enzy. And then 5, if I could put me there, I would, but I can't. So I would say, I'd say like, battling through the spot would be Slap G's and Rich Gliss. But if I had to put someone in front, it would be Slap G's for the 5th. You feel me? But I got a top 10, but we're not gonna get into that. But yeah, that's my top 5.
I mean, so I know that you still, like, you have your little issues going on in the street because you're not the richest rapper out of Harlem. Or that's in New York or whatever. You still got your little street problems going on. But like, when you finally get financially stable, when your record will take off, will you leave the streets? Like, will you get the opportunity? Like, will you?
I would leave the streets, bro. Yeah, I would leave the streets, but it won't be on no pussy bullshit, bro. It would be like if I ever got, like, if I got rich and then moved out the streets. I would never leave the streets. No pussy bullshit. Oh, I'm not that. You feel me? I'm already too deep in the streets. Once you're in the game, there's no leaving unless you're rich type shit. I feel like once you're in the game, there's no leaving unless you die or some shit. But I would never leave the streets.
Well, hey, hopefully you get that opportunity because you got a talent. You got a flow that many others don't have. You got a talent that a lot of people wish they had, you know? So hopefully you get that opportunity, you get that big break in this music business, and then you can move your whole family out one day, you know? Most definitely. Alright, man, so we coming up to wrapping up the end of the interview, you know? Hopefully we can do business again, you know? This was an entertaining interview, most definitely.
Yeah, it was nice doing a business with you, man. I hope I could come and do a second interview or whatever with you. This was a nice little interview. Get to sit down and talk to you. I fuck with you doing for the, you feel me, the Harlem man, all that shit like that. I fuck with what you doing. Keep these up, bro, and I'm gonna meet you again next time.